All right, let's put this over here. And let's try this, just for the hell of it. Now, what I'm thinking. What am I thinking? What I need to do, you know, I'm probably overdoing this or overthinking it or whatever, but I'm using a lot of stuff that I have here. Or should have here. Bar. I'm going to bend this around. And that'll help make sure that this stays together. I'm going to put three of them. I wanted larger, but this is it. But it'll work. I'm going to put this here. That's going to help hold. Before I do any of that, though, I have to do something. To get these down here without losing any support, meaning I don't want to take just a piece of wood down here. Yeah, that's not in the right place. You may not even see this. I don't want to just put on a piece of wood. By no means is it going to be strong enough. Do I have something? For example, I don't want to bolt this on here because it's going to have to come down about another 6 inches and then have all the weight on this piece of board because, again, it's only going to be as safe as its weak flank. So. Or as strong as this week it's link. So this piece here has to be just as sturdy if, or not sturdier than that. But if not the same. So here's where I'm thinking. I cut a piece of scrap that I had just to make the cutouts. I have about 8 feet of this stuff laying around. This is track. Like this, it'll be fine. So what I'm thinking is cutting into this so this can bolt right up to here. It'll be countersunk. Then I can put the pulleys onto this. That's what I'm thinking. And if this is countersunk into here, bolted down into there, I shouldn't have any issues. So, now I do have to go out there and get another measurement because I want these to fall even with the poles out there. So before I start to do any markup on that, let me go out there and get that started. All right, 63. So this is 6'2". Well, actually, where are we at here? Hold on. Yeah, very close. 35. A little under. About 37 1/4 the center. Okay. That's where the center strap will end up going as well. Now, 63 would be 31 1/2. And that's center. That being center, to be here. Deep do I want to go? I don't want to go as deep as this, because I want it to be as even. There. Alright, so that takes care of that side. So that's what I want to do next. I want to cut this out. And down, so that when I do cut a piece that I need, it'll fit right in there. Now, will this do it? Let's see here, hold on. Looks like it might. Oh yeah. But there's a butt. I have to adjust it. And I want to make sure I have the right depth. So I have approximately 2.5 inches. So before I even plug this in, 2.5. Excellent. After I make this cut, I'm going to have my coffee. I need my coffee. Dusty mess of everything here, but the dust I can take care of by just getting the air hose out. You got a sip of coffee, guys. Now I should make multiple cuts, so this will be easier to get out of there, as much as it's going to make a mess. I'm going to move it over here, guys, so you may not see me doing this. If the saw even makes it over here. Yeah, it does. Okay. Putting it over there, it made it a little bit easier because the dust is going on the floor instead of up there. Actually, I could probably just snap them back and forth and break them off. Just for the giggles. Perfect. Now I gotta duplicate this on the other side. And this, like I said, I have about 8 feet of new stuff. And then I have. I should be doing this over there on the other side and not here. However, I've got a project going over there as well. The wife actually has it started. She's finishing off the heat box for the birdhouse. I'll show you in a minute. I'll take you over there. Still has to hook up some of the wire. Okay. perfect. Okay. So that's done. I can get this out of the way. Oh, and by the way, I'm using that real El Cheapo camera. What I will probably do with this one is just keep it in the van. This way, if I, you know, oh shit, I should have brought my camera. You know, I've got this one. I don't use my phone for this kind of stuff. The less I take my phone out of the pocket, the better it is. That's why I don't care too much about, you know, the pixels on the camera and all that. I'm not buying a camera, I'm buying a phone. I will take a picture with it occasionally, if I need to see something that I can't see. You know, because I can take a snapshot of it, and I'm sure you guys do it as well, and then enlarge it. Get the dust out of my nose. Better off doing this and taking it over to the vise instead of trying to bend it around here. So I want to see if this will mark okay first. Yeah, I'd be better off with a marker, probably. Let me get a marker. This isn't quite coarse enough to take the truck. Putting the bark on the top so I know where the mark is on the bottom. Putting up a billboard is hard work and a dirty job. The guys like Gino and Brian and Jimmy, they make it look easy. Of course, advertising has changed over the years. Nowadays, it's all about product placement, product integration, and a whole lot of other techniques. And frankly, I'm not susceptible to, and I'm sure you're not either. All I know okay, is that's this. More than enough. I get myself an extra one. Alright guys, you want to take a walk over there? Anyway, as I was saying, this is the real cheap one. I'm not crazy about it, but I do like the option of it having a microphone that I haven't plugged in yet. So we'll plug that in. Hold on. There. So, because of that option, it's not bad. I have